Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is a quick overview of comparing one nation to another to find out perhaps differences that might reveal why one country is more successful than another, and perhaps a way to analyzing and copying what they're doing. Okay, so here we're looking at the World Economic Index on Heritage for Freedom. It's a multi-score thing that I will explain probably in other videos, but suffice it to say, this chart, we have several indexes. So on the left side has a score from 0 to 100, and it doesn't normalize down to 0, so this is slightly skewed depending on what index you're measuring. This is over years and over time, so 1995 to the year 2018. I have several countries here. Let's compare it. So blue is Hong Kong. Singapore is kind of yellow gold. USA is gray. Lavender is the world average. And this sort of pink, coral pink, is Venezuela, my favorite country to not to mock, but to avoid. In any case, now we see that these countries vary over time. Let's just get to it. Overall score, I'm not even going to explain these like I did in some other videos. It's just to give you a general holistic point of view. So overall score will tell us how all the countries are comparing, and we could clearly see that in the overall score, Venezuela is a dismal failure. Overall score of economic freedom, a combination of political freedom, monetary freedom, and other forms of freedom, and freedom from corruption. Venezuela scores down, not necessarily the lowest. That would be interesting to see which country does perform the lowest one day. Then we go up to 61% for a world average. Okay, fine. Then we go to 75% for America. Now some, and then higher to 90, score of 90 for Singapore, and nearly the same for Hong Kong. I am using these countries, both Singapore and Hong Kong, because lately they are not necessarily the fastest growing, but they're becoming the freest and wealthiest per person nations on this planet. We should look to them for as role models to see what they are doing that we're not doing, and study it, analyze it, perhaps emulate. I'll leave that up to you to decide what's the proper approach, but certainly worth of discussion. Now, just to quickly go through these, and I'm not going to explain them like I have. The explanations are available on both Wikipedia here, where they go through the explanations, and they also show you the charts from a different way that you may or may not like. Basically, we're talking about, they explain what rule of law and property rights are. Okay, fine. This is also described as methodology that you could find on the Heritage website under methodology. Let's go back to the map. So here we have a map, and let's just quickly bear in mind these countries, blue once again, gold, gray being USA, pink being world average, and Venezuela being the coral pink. Now you could see over time, at one time Venezuela was not too bad in 1995, and yet they went lower and lower and lower and lower and lower. The question is, how low can they go? I don't think there's any limit. Basically. So, okay, let's just get to the nitty-gritty, quickly compare it to the different indexes that make up this overall score, and that's composed of property rights, judicial effectiveness, and all these other parameters that I've explained in another video. Property rights? Well, look, we could see that property rights are really crap, almost zero in Venezuela. Don't bother buying anything. Somebody or the government will take it away. Property rights around the world, 51.5%, not too good, which might explain why the world is having the predicament that it is. USA, well look, we used to be much higher in the past, where both the blue and the other countries simultaneously imposed at 90%, but then it started to diverge and America started to lose its way on protection of property rights via court systems and all other methods to protect your the rights of your property via systematic processes. Judicial effectiveness, how corrupt the governments are, I mean the judges are, the court system. And here this doesn't go back in time, but we do see tremendous differences between them. Let's just go through these. Big difference between all of them. Tax burden, government spending. Once again, big differences between these countries. Fiscal health, freedom to run a business, labor freedom to hire a person, how onerous, how many permits, does the government make too many regulations, what about unions, how money is handled via the government, via monetary policy, via interference with interest rates and the Federal Reserve and the Treasury, trade freedom, investment freedom. Well, look at Venezuela here. Probably now Venezuela has become so dysfunctional, there probably is no investment freedom, which is why it no longer is scored. Financial freedom. Okay, now these things might be interesting for you to compare. In my pursuit here, I purposely picked out these countries. You can pick out any that you care to compare. Let's look at another way of seeing this, and that's the map. And once again, on the Heritage website, you can hover above any of these countries and see in comparing to the scale here, that the tax burden in USA is higher. In other words, it has a lower score than Canada. Canada seems to be doing better. Any of the lighter greens, let's just see, okay, now I see. It changed slight color, so be careful of this. Look more into the chart to get deeper information. In any case, we see the darkest green. Now, there might be a little dark green here. I forgot what that is. It's too small for me to see. But in any case, Australia, they're having a slightly better score on us in terms of tax burden, worthy to note. Now look at failed countries here, look what China's doing. I don't want to call them failed countries, let's just say they're not respecting their citizens possibly, and it eventually is corrosive. We could see Venezuela here, I can't even see the chart here, pretty abysmal. So you can then compare these countries going through the various buttons, government spending, and just make your own study. One of these days I'll go through this as a map. Another place that you'll find further explanations is once again on Wikipedia, where they give you the methodology that they explain that. Excellent. Okay, this has just been an overview. Look for my other YouTube videos that might go into this deeper.